like to sort of get more songs in films and more artists again recording our songs. So that would be a bit. Because, I mean, we've had a lot of that lately, internationally. And Take That with How Deep Is Your Love. Number one. We've had two number ones in the UK. I think any artist that is being heard and appreciated and is getting recognised what they're doing will always find that it's easier to be creative in a more positive direction. Nothing succeeds, I should say, more than success. And if you're having success, you can create more success. It's almost like, you know, if you've got money, money creates money, you know, and it's the same with success. It's the same, you know, failure has no friends and success has no sympathy. And so it's that same kind of role. So, you know, the bottom line is that you have to be strong enough when you're an artist just to isolate yourself from what people say and get on with what you think is your best work.
Doing this kind of work and writing these kind of songs we've been writing lately, I mean, we seem to have come up and got better with what we're doing rather than going, which people sometimes tend to think that you start to suffer as you get older, you know. But as we've been writing lately, I've been blown away with some of the stuff I've been doing.
It's obviously a great honour to work on an album with other tracks being produced by Arif and Russ Titelman and David Foster and people like that. They're all my heroes. Working with the Bee Gees has been everything I expected and more.
We really love what we do. And coming out of Sizes and Everything, the last album, I felt more... Everybody wanted to go on tour, but I was far more fired up about the idea of continuing to record because I thought we were going somewhere. And when you take off on tour and you give away 6 months of your life to live shows, you stop creating. And that doesn't apply to everybody, but it certainly applies to us. We either have to be in live show mode or tour mode, or we have to be in creative music mode, and it's two different ways of life. And we're about to slip into live mode now. Whoops.
In terms of mountains to climb, I don't think you can keep thinking in terms of mountains to climb. I think you've just got to enjoy what you're doing and write the music that you feel is the best you're doing in your life. It's like a painter, you know. You just keep painting. An artist can't put a limit on when he stops creating. And if he's doing his best works, then it's for him to feel he's doing his best works and not... It's great when he gets critical approval, obviously, but it's I think you have to stop thinking in terms of mountains, and just, you know, if you get the mountains and you're climbing, then you've got to be doing them unwittingly at a point by just doing the best you can. I think if you see a mountain and say go for it, you lose sight of what work you're doing. If you do the work, then you'll reach the mountain without thinking about it.
We're really still three Manchester kids that live in the dream. Because, I mean, I'm sure you know the story, but when we did it many years ago, the fact that Barry and the two of us were walking down the street in Manchester and it was raining, and I was about, I think, six, and Barry was about nine, and he said, one day we're going to be famous.
As a fan, I just thought, next to the Beatles, they were probably the most creative group ever.
When I hear them, I definitely stop what I'm doing and I just listen, you know what I mean?
They're, you know, seasoned and great record makers and great singers.
Did they change the face of music?
I don't feel like I'm ever peaking, or the three of us don't think we're ever peaking. I certainly don't think we're ever peaking. We're just continuing in the next step, and for whatever that next step will take us.
I think Smoke and Mirrors is a really important statement. The world of illusion, the idea that none of us are really what we seem to be. All of these songs are not just songs as such. There's a lot of examination of yourself in these songs. The true listener will notice that, and somebody who's just looking for a hit single won't notice that. It's my own sign.